China is without a strong leader and has descended into civil war. Zhao Guangying, chief commander of the Imperial Guard, is a powerful and popular figure. On a winter's night, his loyal guards surround his quarters near Kaifeng, cheering their support. Over dinner, his officers drop to their knees and declare him emperor. Now Emperor Taizu, he found the Song dynasty, which unites China and brings peace and the golden age of culture and science. With the image of the Optimus Primal included in this tracing, he is a representation of science and technology in various ways. Optimus Primal emphasizes the importance of collaborations and teamwork between the maximum faction. This is very much like Emperor Taizu and his clique. This mirrors the collaborative nature of scientific and technological advancements, often requiring interdisciplinary efforts for breakthroughs. Emperor Taizu was the founder of Song Dynasty in China. He ruled from 960 to 976 and played a key role in unifying the country after the fragmentation of the Tang Dynasty. Taizu's reign marked the beginning of the Northern Song period, characterized by economic prosperity and cultural achievements. In the early 10th century, China was in turmoil, fragmented by regional warlords. Amidst the chaos emerged a visionary leader who would reshape the course of history. He is no other than Emperor Taizu. Taizu rose from humble beginnings to become a military genius. His charisma and strategic brilliance caught the attention of those seeking stability in a fractured land. People hope and yearn for unity, and there it begins. In 960, Emperor Taizu achieved the impossible, unifying China under the banner of the Song Dynasty. This marked the beginning of a new chapter for the nation. He once said, "We shall build a dynasty that stands the test of time, fostering prosperity and cultural flourishing." Taizu then went on to implement groundbreaking economic reforms, encouraging trade and innovation. The Grand Canal flourished, connecting the vast empire and fueling economic growth. Merchants were known to say that the policies of Emperor Taizu have brought prosperity and that their markets thrived. Taizu's reign witnessed a cultural renaissance. Flourishing art, literature, and philosophy became the hallmark of the Northern Song period. Emperor Taizu's legacy endures as the Song Dynasty became a beacon of stability, innovation, and cultural refinement. His vision shaped the course of Chinese history for centuries to come. In the annals of time, Emperor Taizu stands as a testament to the transformative power of leadership. His legacy echoes through the ages, reminding us of the enduring impact one visionary ruler can have on a nation. In the 10th century, as Emperor Taizu ascended the throne, China entered an era of profound transformation, blending tradition with technological innovation. Taizu, recognizing the importance of technology, envisioned a realm where science and innovation would propel the Song Dynasty into a new age. He understood that the future and the mastery of knowledge and marvels of science would propel the Song Dynasty forward. Taizu spearheaded agricultural innovations, introducing efficient plowing techniques and irrigation systems that significantly boosted food production, and this was important in that era for people. Emperor Taizu's advancements have made tilling the land more efficient, and hence their harvests were improved. The Song Dynasty, under Taizu's guidance, became a maritime powerhouse. Technological advancements in shipbuilding and navigation expanded trade routes and cultural exchanges. With the Emperor's support, their ships sailed confidently, connecting them with distant land and cultures. Emperor Taizu fostered a culture of invention, leading to remarkable advancements in mechanical engineering and automation. His embracement of technology and science laid the foundation for a flourishing dynasty. His commitment to progress echoes in the corridors of time, shaping the destiny of China. Now, as we look back and reflect on the reign of Emperor Taizu, we see not only a unifier of a fractured land, but He is very much a visionary who understood that science and technology is key to a prosperous and enduring future. And I have to say, he is right. Look at what we are using now. It's the AI period. The technological renaissance he ignited continues to inspire generations. Astrologer excitedly points to the night sky. He is persuading the men that the position of the planets indicates that Zhao Kangying is the rightful emperor. Daoguang Inn's secretary dresses him in the imperial robe, a symbol of power. Here's a love story of Emperor Taizu. Where the tale of love unfolded, the untold romance of Emperor Taizu begins. In the bustling capital, Taizu, a powerful founder, found his heart captivated by a woman of extraordinary grace and intellect, Lady Mei. Their love, however, was not without challenges. The imperial court was a stage for political intrigue and power struggle. In secret, Taizu and Lady Mei exchanged heartfelt letters expressing their deepest emotions amidst the secrecy of the palace. Despite the constraints, Taizu and Lady Mei managed to meet secretly, stealing moments of passion and intimacy in the shadows of the imperial palace. As the challenges grew, Taizu and Lady Mei faced the inevitable. A choice between duty and love. I think this must be quite common for emperors of China in the past. The sense of duty is strong if not imposed by the court, but also they are humans, and the search for love must go on. Well, in the end, Taizu was known to say that for the empire, he must go on, but his heart will forever carry the imprint of the love for Lady Mei. Brings about the conclusion of the sex story. The love story of Emperor Taizu and Lady Mei, though hidden in annals of the history, speaks of human heart's resilience against the constraints of power and duty. In the corridors of the Imperial Palace, their love remained an endearing flame, a testament to the human spirit's ability to transcend the boundaries imposed by the world. Is it a happy or sad ending? I'm not so sure. In the fictional narrative, the love story of Emperor Taizu and Lady Mei takes a bittersweet turn, leaning towards a sad ending. As the demands of the empire intensified, Emperor Taizu and Lady Mei faced the harsh reality of their forbidden love. Of course, as duty called, and Taizu, burdened by the weight of the crown, made the heart-wrenching decision to protect the stability of the dynasty.
Thank you.
officers toast to the new emperor with wine served in jade cups. The soldiers will tuck into a hearty meal of hot pot, dipping meat and vegetables into a simmering broth. Optimus Primal exemplifies leadership through strategic thinking and adaptability. His ability to analyze situations and adjust his tactics mirrors the importance of adaptability in the ever-evolving landscape of science and technology. As a transformer, Optimus Primal is a fusion of organic and technological elements. This symbolizes the interconnectedness of nature and technology, emphasizing the potential for harmony between the two realms in advancement of scientific pursuits. Optimus Primal embodies the idea that advancements in science and technology can be harnessed for the greater good, driving progress and improvement.
Cheetor, maximize!
Well, as most of us and many of us would have known, Optimus Primal often takes on the role of a guardian. protecting the vast knowledge and technological innovations of the Transformers. This reflects the responsibilities that comes with scientific progress, of course. The need to safeguard knowledge for benefit of future generations. In various Transformers storylines you may have watched in the movies, Optimus Primal leads his team in exploring not only Earth, but also venturing into space. This symbolizes the frontier spirit of scientific exploration, pushing the boundaries of knowledge and technology to new heights. Optimus Primal consistently advocates for the ethical use of technology. His character reflects the importance of considering the broader implications and ethical dimensions of scientific advancements, ensuring they contribute positively to society. In essence, Optimus Primal stands out not only as a fictional character in a science fiction universe, but also as a symbolic representation of the principles and values associated with the responsible pursuit and application of science and technology.
We Maximals are an advanced race, dedicated to the expansion of life throughout the universe. When Unicron destroyed our world, we took an oath dedicated to the preservation of life.
One interesting aspect of the Song dynasty is in its relations between its traditional culture and the introduction of science. As you can see in the tracing, I have put together the scene where he was made emperor and a picture of a Transformer Optimus Primal together. And this kind of celebrates the togetherness of the two elements that I mentioned earlier.